but we gradually came back to it as sort of a way of celebration. So, with a lot of help from a lot of people, I think I have this black robe back on. They never took the hat off. This is a Benjamin Luther hat, by the way, came from Germany. But they never took the hat off in the churches because there was no heat. Maybe they took them off in the summer. But the only time I've seen a Luther that was exactly like Luther's in was in Lent one year. I was in upper Germany, but we crossed over into Poland. Used to be Lutheran, is now Catholic, but I went to the Wednesday evening Lenten service they were having in Polish, so I didn't understand too much of it either. But one thing for sure, it was cold in there, and they all had all of their clothes on because churches don't have heat in at least much of the northern part of Europe. All of that said, welcome to Reformation Sunday. It's the one Sunday of the year that we take a rather close look about how Luther came about in relationship to the Scriptures. So, as you are able, stand, and we begin with our confession and forgiveness with these words: Blessed be the Holy Trinity, the one who fashions us, the one who heals us, the one who reforms us again and again. Amen. Let us confess our sin, calling for God. The love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with you, the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another, or say to each other, Know the Lord. For they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Well, now read responsibly Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Therefore, we will not fear, even though the earth be
shatters the spear and burns the shields with fire.
Be still then and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Here ends the reading. The second reading is from Romans chapter 3. Now we know that whatever the law says, it speaks to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced, and the whole world may be held accountable to God. For no human being will be justified in his sight by deeds prescribed by the law, for through the law comes the knowledge of sin. But now, apart from law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed and is attested by the law and the prophets. The righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith. He did this to show his righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he had passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous and that he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus. Then what becomes of boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of works? No. But by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by the law. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Romans had a great deal to do with the Lutheran Reformation. He sent others also to clarify the scriptures after Jesus had ascended. Sometimes that caused the church having to reform. And so we understand when we have a Reformation Sunday that Reformation is still necessary always in our lives of faith, and in some ways even in the church. The church is pretty slow to reform, of course, but there have been great reformers along the way. One of them that I would give you the invitation to buy and to read are the Confessions of St. Augustine. St. Augustine, of course, was the one whose message of faith created the Augustinian monks, and Luther became an Augustinian monk when he was nearly struck by lightning and prayed, "Saint Anne, please save me, I'll become a monk." And he did, and he did a whole lot more. But anyway, read Augustine's Confession, because I do it some practically three or four times a year. In his confession, I always am amazed how clearly he writes and how clearly he says some things. Have a good time sinning. Sin is a lot of fun. That's St. Augustine. And it was those same sins, of course, that he had to confess. St. Augustine had a mistress, and that mistress and he had a son, Odoacer, and they were not interested, and Augustine was certainly not interested in confessing or changing his life until around age 35, sitting in a pub, having a glass, maybe too many. Certainly not against wine, are we? But there he heard monks who sang, going by singing this part of the scripture. It's interesting to see how different the world was in the day of St. Augustine, and in some ways not too much different 1,100 years later with Luther. But people couldn't read and write. Mostly. And so the monks were trained to sing the scriptures. They may not be able to read either, by the way, that they had just memorized. And it was, of course, that part of Romans, which you just heard read, and it also changed the life of St. Augustine. And now, 1,100 years later, Luther as well. I always find it interesting, something for you and me both to remember, that we can know the scriptures a long time. so much by lay people, even the few that could read in the days before Luther came along. It was considered, somebody wrote once, to be about as we had looked at the writings of Marx and Engels, who put together the word framework of communism. That's kind of the way the people of Luther's day looked at him, as the leadership.
us pray. With confidence in God's grace and mercy, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Renew and inspire the church in the freedom of the gospel, O God. Where the church is in error, reform it. Where the church speaks your truth, strengthen it. Where the church is divided, unite it. Ignite in us the working of the Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
As the earth changes, as mountains shake and the waters roar, may we care for this planet as a holy habitation for all living things. Sustain all peoples and lands, recovering from the natural disasters of any kind, especially those hit by the hurricanes and the wildfires. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide areas of the world divided or traumatized by conflict, especially in our own land. Free all from slavery and human trafficking, and protect all in harm's way. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Release those living in bondage to deaths, chronic pain, or addiction. Grant healing touch to those who are ill, especially those on our prayer list, and those who remain in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
In this family of faith, we give thanks for the courageous voices that have remained firm in their commitment to the one who frees us from sin today. Centered in your grace, unify us in the hope of the gospel. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Even in death, you free us and give us a place in your house. We give thanks for our ancestors who have shown us truth and freedom, especially Martin Luther and those who work for the renewal of the church. Raise up those who have died in you, especially Baron Kamen. We give thanks for their witness, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Listen as we call on you, O God, and enfold in your loving arms all for whom we pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
And we prepare for Holy Communion.
Anybody else? Let's have the sending hymn. Seated.